There are three things, takeaways, if you will, I want to share with you about Dr. Tolbert's meaningful life. People, possessions, and profession. People, possessions, and profession. People, as chair of Howard's history department for a dozen years and professor for 30, Dr. Tolbert prioritized people. His students loved him for his deep knowledge, yes, for his chill and relatable personality, yes, but perhaps most for his ability to guide PhD students to successfully defend their dissertations and to graduate. I can't tell you how many doctoral students, including me, are indebted to Dr. Tolbert in this way. In fact, when my dissertation had reached 800 pages, Dr. Tolbert called me and said, "Ben, research is never over, but you have to end it at some point. It has to be discreet." If we were Catholic, we may refer to Dr. Tolbert as the patron saint of history graduate students. Possessions. Dr. Tolbert was reputed to have one of the largest personal collections of historic African-American manuscripts and artifacts. Periodicals, correspondence, rare books, clothing, art, images, media. If you visited his archive, you were wowed by the meticulous care and organization. Dr. Tolbert dedicated hundreds of hours to creating it because he deeply believed that Black lives matter. Finally, profession. For all his academic responsibilities and scholarship, he was one of the world's leading authorities on Marcus Garvey. And by the way, he interviewed my great-grandmother for his dissertation on Garvey, as she was a Garveyite in Louisiana. But despite this, Dr. Tolbert employed his expertise for his faith community. He was a charter and lifelong member of the Sabbath in Africa Study Group. He published books on local churches and biographies on E.J. Humphrey and R.L. Woodfork. He cultivated Adventist scholars. He gave history lectures for church programs, you name it. His church was important to him, and he used his professional gifts in its service. People, possessions, profession. Thank you, Dr. Tolbert.